Hi everybody, my name is Mauro Scandiuzzo, Field Application Engineer for STMicroelectronics. I'm an expert of ST sensors. Thanks to coming here today at the Sensor Expo, I want to present to you, introduce a new development tool that ST put in place that is called AlgoBuilder. AlgoBuilder is a useful tool to design, prototype your algorithm based on our sensor, our STM32 microcontroller, build up your idea like a building block, generate your code without actually writing the C code, but just using function block and integrate everything together, and in order also to able to generate your code, flash on your STM32 eval board and see directly with a graphical user interface called Unicleo the effect of your algorithm. Let's go in detail how it works this tool. Okay, this is how it looks like the AlgoBuilder. So you have several tabs here to save the file, save the project, and manage the firmware. First things, the AlgoBuilder works with several kind of tool chain. In this particular case, I'm using System Workbench, but you can use also IAR and also Kale. Obviously, you need to link also the graphical user interface, Unicleo, if you want to use it. How, what do you have here on the left side? You have a lot of block, a lot of building blocks that you can use to build up your algorithm. You have, let's say, mathematical function, you have comparison function, constant, display, graphical, logical operator, math operator. You have also advanced library like sensor fusion to generate quaternion. You have also the possibility to conditionate the signal and also to work on the sensor app. Let's try to do something easy together. So we have our hardware coming back is the Nucleo board. In particular case, we have an L4, Cortex-M4, but low power version, running 80 megahertz, and we have the expansion board with all our sensors. So this is the algo, the algorithm that I generate. So I have a sensor hub. I want to get from the sensor hub just the acceleration, actually three axes, X, Y, and Z. That is why I customize the graph block. And then now what I want to do. First of all, I need to generate the code. So I need to compile it, build the firmware. So the first step will be using this block, this particular button to generate the program. I'm using now System Workbench. At this point, I can really see the code that I generated. This is pretty easy because I'm just displaying the accelerometer. I can close it and I can flash on the board directly from the graphical user interface, directly from the AlgoBuilder. We generate. The process is finalized, I finish and I program the board. I can open the graphical user interface in order to see the effect of that directly on a graph. Now in this sense, I can see the accelerometer, the three-axis accelerometer, the gravity is on the z-axis, is negative. If I flip over, I can see then the gravity go in from minus 1g to 1g. That is a very easy example to make aware of, let's say, a very starting point to become familiar with the tool. Let's assume that I want to open a more complex algorithm. In this particular example, I take all the features from the sensor hub, not only the accelerometer, but also I want to generate the quaternion with a sensor fusion algorithm. I want to also calculate the magnetic field. I want to also catch the temperature, humidity, and also the different magnetic field from the three axes. I need, first of all, generate the code and flash directly after in my Nucleo board in order to make sure that everything is generating, no error. I can flash that directly. That is, I want to take a look also at the code. I can see the code here, it is generated. When you press the Unicleo button to see the display, it's come up like this. You have the information about the graphical user interface. You have also the data logging here. and also the kind of hardware that you are using then for the sensor part. Here the data logging and also the data auto display. So what do you have? You have the quadrennion here, you have the acceleration, you have also the logic analyzer here, and the magnetic field temperature and humidity. So that is what you display based on the code that you generate and the graph that you would like to display. That is really, in short, a different kind of example, but to show you the potential of this AlgoBuilder graphical user interface. Thank you for your attention.